One day I want to see my basic research fundamentally change the way people live in the future. My name is Peidong Yang. I'm a chemistry professor at the University of California, Berkeley. I'm also a senior faculty scientist at Lawrence Berkeley National Lab. My general area of research is about semiconductor nanowires. It's a special class of semiconductor nanostructure with very interesting physical properties. Nanowire basically is one type of nanostructure. It's very much like a human hair, but it's 100 times or 1,000 times thinner.
Well, in this little square, there are millions and millions of silicon nanowires. Oh, yeah.
Many of our work on the basic optical property studies of semiconductor nanostructure can now be used for the designing of new solar cell, designing of new systems for artificial photosynthesis so that we can convert water, CO2, using sunlight into many useful chemicals like butanol, acetate, or methane. In nature, green leaf basically takes in CO2, absorbs sunlight, and do the photosynthesis so that they can convert that CO2 into very useful chemical compounds and release oxygen back into the environment. And that's the process we want to mimic, utilizing unique type of nanostructure nowadays we can make in the lab.
Well, effectively, this is what we typically call as synthetic leaf, because they are doing the same function as the green leaf.
We are converting solar energy and store them into chemical bond. Artificial photosynthesis is a process of energy conversion and storage. As a material chemist, I like to do basic research. In the meantime, also, I have great interest to use this basic knowledge to do something useful. Even though this is still at an earlier stage, artificial photosynthesis is considered as one of sustainable future technology. And you can also consider it's potentially give you the carbon neutral solution.